Our lab at College of Forestry, Wildlife and Environment at Auburn University focuses on trying to solve real-world problems dealing with forest health to help industry members, to help private landowners, state entities manage their forests for disease and insects to keep them healthy.
The forestry and related sectors contribute $34 billion to the state economy. And the College of Forestry, Wildlife and Environment serves as the backbone to these organizations by providing quality professionals, supporting with new knowledge, and also disseminating science-based solutions to these organizations.
Brown spot needle blight is a pathogen in longleaf pine. It's easily managed through fire in the grass stage. It now is in loblolly pine, which we're not quite sure how we'll manage it because now it's way up in the canopy and not easily burned.
With as much loblolly that's planted in the southeast, this pathogen has a potential to cripple our forest industry because just my little slice of the world, thousands of acres just of stuff I manage are either dead or dying. You invest a lot of money in creating those plantations, and the brown spot needle blight attacks those plantations before they are merchantable.
At the beginning, we had a landowner that actually donated the money that allowed us to start the project. We were able to get enough preliminary data and also enough of the constituents in the state saying, we have a problem and Auburn needs to be working on this.
The Needle Blight Research Project, funded by the U.S. Forest Service, is bringing researchers from multiple disciplines and also stakeholders from the government, non-governmental, and the private sector to work collaboratively to address this issue.
That grant enabled us to bring in 5 graduate students, 8 regular undergrads that work full-time on the project, and then every summer we hire 4 summer interns that come and work with the graduate students and the students. We're at our north location for our brown spot needle blight grant. The students have their study plots here, and we come up here 1 week out of every month, and we take a multitude of samplings from the trees, from the soil, from the surrounding area, trying to get a feel of how the pathogen is actually affecting the trees.
Being with a diverse team has been really fun. I've learned a lot. We have students on this project from out of the country, and it's really eye-opening because forestry is a global need, and being out here with everyone in the lab is very fun. I see them more than my family back home, so we get along really well. We have a lot of fun.
All of our samples are up in trees that are from 30 feet to 100 feet, so we have to take those with a .22 Magnum rifle. All of the students help each other take all of their data. So the physiology students learn what the GIS students are doing, which learn the soil portion and learn the environmental aspects. So there's, I think, really more collaboration in the group than if we're just sitting in a lab and sitting in our offices.
We're all kind of looking at a different aspect. The soil is part of my project. We're looking at if soil nutrient levels and soil texture, soil type, plays a role on disease spread, whereas my colleagues, some of them are looking at, is there a genetic component to this disease spread? Another is looking at the actual disease. So we all kind of have our own little aspect of it.
We are analyzing genomic data from various infected pine stands to try to understand if infections in loblolly are primarily due to spread from longleaf, or if they perhaps originate from other sources, like maybe other infected loblolly stands, or maybe even environmental sources. Understanding this helps us determine the movement patterns of these spores and provides insights into how and why the pathogen might be capable of infecting this new host species.
Drone-based imagery and LiDAR enable very fine scale information that can inform where the disease is occurring across a landscape and also update those maps with remote sensing data to get an idea of where they're at and how that disease is progressing. Remote sensing allows for the generation of spatially comprehensive or spatially explicit information. By utilizing remotely sensed data, we're able to generate that spatially comprehensive information that can represent baseline in the case of brown spot needle blight, baseline detection, and enable further monitoring of brown spot needle blight.
Communication between Forestry Commission and other state government agencies and land grant schools and research institutes is vital to getting the message out to landowners. Make sure they understand the potential effects that brown spot needle blight can have on their land and making sure they know how to respond to it.
As the study moves along, we want to keep the community involved, the stakeholders, be their main resource of how things are going, what have we learned so far, and we do this through meetings and workshops and meet with landowners, meeting with the AFC and other folks to just keep that out. We even have a website that is just dedicated to this project.
I think it's really great for the students to understand how they think they're coming to the field. They're having a really good time. They're doing their research. They're making new friends. They're making new contacts through the landowners and the company people they meet. But in essence, what they're doing is really gonna affect how trees are managed across the state of Alabama and how it impacts the economy.